IPL, I mean, I know when IPL started, there was a school of thought which said, there goes cricket. There was a school of thought which said...
It was there comes cricket.
In the sense, there goes cricket, what I meant was everyone knew cricket as a five-day game. You know, money was there, but, you know, this kind of seemed like an explosion happening. And there were periods of time when some of those fears seemed justified. There was a few scams which happened, and then everyone pinpointed that one single thing called IPL and blamed it. But now in the context of 5, 7, 8, 9 years, it looks like a concept which has created tremendous value virtually out of nothing, and all credit to the gentleman who thought up of the idea and all of the others who actually sustained it. And it does also seem, you know, like as if IPL has actually generated genuine talent for the game. The fielding standards have improved. And then there's an IPL in India, but now, just like you mentioned, the Caribbean Premier League just got over last night. The Big Bash is big in Australia. So, I mean, you know, how do you define that phenomenon? In the sense, it's a completely new format, completely seemingly money-centric, but seems to have also done great stuff for the game of cricket as well. Would you agree with the assessment?
If your market wants a snazzy looking two-seater that gives you 40 kilometers to the liter, and you say, right, that's what you want, but here is a 10-seater truck that gives you 4 kilometers to the liter, that is what real transport is, and that is what you must buy. What's the kid going to do? He'll buy it because he's got no choice. But the moment someone offers a snazzy two-seater that gives 40 kilometers to the liter, he'll say, yeah, that's what I want, right? So a product offering, as we all know in advertising, I also spent 2 years in advertising. As all the business people know here, you have to have a product that appeals to your market. Otherwise, it's not much good having a product. And everything changes with passage of time. I mean, today I've got, there's no one in the watch industry here, no? We've got 5 watches in the house that people have gifted us, and I tell children, you know, you've got a really nice watch at home. Do you want a watch? And he said, a watch? For what? And I said, a watch because it tells time. He said, my phone tells time. So there's no point. I mean, product categories are going out. This was just one form of the game that needed to get modernized. It's not that Test cricket was only noble and IPL was only evil, or that IPL is only contemporary and Test cricket is all hopeless. But each has qualities that are nice and not so nice. This was just very contemporary, very snazzy. And I think somebody in business has to ask themselves, what industry are we in? Is cricket in the industry of cricket? Or is cricket in the overall industry of entertainment?
Yep.
And if cricket's in the industry of entertainment, do you have movies that run for 5 days without a result? Can you imagine sitting in a cinema theater for 5 days and at the end not knowing the hero gets a heroine in the end?
Yep.
Whereas you want to, so a 3-hour sport was just made for the times. So
a lot of people who say that, you know, this is only about money and things like that. First of all, money only comes to a product that's well designed and marketed well. And that's why the money has come in. But the people who say that, you know, Test cricket is the real thing are really people from our generation or older. The younger generation doesn't seem to say that. For them, IPL is the real thing.
But has it improved cricket?
What is cricket? Is cricket batting for a day and a half to save a match, which is damn tough to do? Or is cricket saying, I need 18 to score from 6 balls, packed house, final of a tournament? Is that easy to do? So there are different things that are all difficult to do. But over the course of time, we have said that batting for a day and a half to save a test match is difficult. But also, that is the only thing that is difficult. And the guy saying, look man, 14 to score of 3 balls, right? I'm having to go 6-6-4 or 6-4-4 to win the title. You think it's easy? 6-4-4 and 3 balls to win a game? It's a different skill. It's a different kind of difficulty that you're very good at. And so you cannot undermine that difficulty because we have got used to something being... So if making Mughal-e-Azam was difficult, is telling an entire product story in 20 seconds easy? I've only got 20 seconds because the moment I go into 22 seconds, I'm in a 30-second slot that cost me 1/3 more money, so my ad budget is all gone. Is telling an entire story in 10 seconds easy to do? If you had 90 seconds, everybody would do it, right? So I think it's like that there are levels of difficulty to everything. Because we've all grown up believing something was great, You think AB de Villiers playing a reverse lap shot to Dale Steyn, bowling at 140 kilometers an hour and changing the shot at the last minute and playing it there is easy?
Yeah,
no. Mm. So Gavaskar batting against four fast bowlers and battling them with half broken fingers was difficult. This is also difficult, but in a different way.
See what it's done to the game. Look at the opportunity.
Sure.
Not only for young Indian players, but for international stars, for, you know, players from, let's say, Bangladesh or Afghanistan, and the whole ecosystem that it's created, you know, trainers, physiotherapists, coaches, the whole
absolutely
thing. It's only been good for the game, I think.
No, absolutely.
And to be fair, more people can be good over half an hour than can be good over 5 days. Let's be honest. It's easier to be good over half an hour than to be good over 5 days.
Sure.
And so more and more people are getting in. There was a time when Indian cricket had a lot of money. 15, 16 people made money out of that. 18 people might have made money if they were on contracts. 100 plus people are making money out of the IPL. Today, the Karnataka Premier League, the Tamil Nadu Premier League, there's a Jharkhand Premier League.
Yeah.
Where you're not making in crores, but there are players who are making 50, 60,000. There's some people who are making 4, 5 lakhs, but they're making 4, 5 lakhs in something they love doing, and the scouts are watching them. So there is this player who's seen in the Tamil Nadu Premier League. He must have been on 50,000 rupees. And people said, gee, man, this kid is different. He got a 3.2 crore contract in the IPL. So all of a sudden, you're getting more and more people into the game. And it's moving with the times. I don't know how long it'll last. It's still a child. The IPL is a child. T20 is a child. The 90-minute football game has survived over the years, and you know that it can. Cricket is the only sport that's played across three formats. Football is not played across three formats. There's a futsal, which is six-a-side, seven-a-side, played on a small ground that's not taken off. But cricket is the only sport that's played over so many formats. So we'll have to wait and see whether T20 becomes boring. So we'll wait and see. Already, the scores of 220, 200, 220 in a T20 game, and we're not going, wow, 200. So already we're getting immune to 200 scores. So let's see how long T20 lasts. I don't know. People are saying, will there be a T10? Well, I don't know if there'll be a T10. Will there be a 5-over game? We already have a 5-over game.
Sure.
Will cricket become a 1-over game? We already have a 1-over game to resolve a tie. So you don't know where it's going. Eventually, it's what the public wants.